cursed state of this place. Sam and Dave have really let it go downhill since they haven't had to keep it spruced up for kitchen suppers for their party dinners. I bet Dave wishes many of the measures in this had been binned before they were announced to the country. Budget 2012, known in polite circles as an omni-shambles, and in others as a clusterfuck, has caused no end of trouble for the government. Pasty tax, granny tax, and now the Chancellor's decision to limit the amount of tax relief that top-rate taxpayers can get back from their charity giving. He was supposed to be bashing the rich, but now he's being accused of bashing charities because their income's going to fall by about £500 million. Well, it looks like Dave's now realised what a mess his neighbours have been making.
This was never going to be introduced until next year. Plenty of time to get it right, plenty of time to consult and to listen. But the key principle is more for charities and philanthropic giving, yes, but allowing people to drive their tax rate down to 10% when they're some of the richest people in the country.
Oh, this must have been here a few years. I could get a few bob on eBay for this. This guy here made a rare visit to the TV studios this week to give the current Prime Minister some advice.
What they should do, I think, now they've got the time, and look, I've been through many situations like this. Sometimes things slip through, they're not right. You've got the chance with a consultation to correct them. And the important thing is to correct them and not end up in a battle with the philanthropic sector that I think they'll find it difficult to win.
Now the government's in right lather. Some of its proposals, like the charity stuff, were perfectly thought out. But others, like the granny tax and the pasty tax, are perfectly justifiable. Just really badly sold. Well, the ministers have been so scalded by the bad press that they're not prepared to stand their ground. It's all a complete mess. Ed's starting to clean up. Latest poll giving him a 9-point lead. If Ken Livingstone doesn't win the London mayoral election, and if Labour loses control of Glasgow City Council at the local elections, then those mutterings against Ed Miliband's leadership could start up all over again. But none of the political leaders is immune, because Tory backbenchers are muttering about Cameron's leadership and the loss of grip in number 10. And meanwhile, poor old Nick Clegg is watching his party's ratings go down the plug hole. Bet he longs for those sunny days of summer 2010. The clean up Walmart will wipe the blues away. The clean up Walmart to sweep them off. Oh, I need a breather. George Galloway returned to the House of Commons for the third time this week. Well, let's hope he remembers which constituency he's representing, because after the by-election in Bradford West, he tweeted that he was a new MP for Blackburn. It must be so confusing going all the way from Scotland to London to somewhere up in the northwest. The Prime Minister took the opportunity at PMQs to welcome him back, but mainly to have a dig at Ed Miliband, whose party really should have held Bradford West.
Let's have a look at his last month. He lost the Bradford by-election. That was a great success. I have to say, he has given one person a job opportunity, George Galloway.
Meanwhile, Ken Livingstone's had to come clean about his own tax affairs. This from a man who said that tax avoiders were rich bastards who shouldn't be allowed to vote, which of course gives Cameron a sitting target.
We've got a Labour candidate for Mayor of London who's paying less tax on his earnings than the person who cleans his office. I think that's disgraceful. Why won't he condemn it?
Oh, isn't that nice? I thought he only cared about rich people. He certainly cares about Boris, though, because if Boris wins London again, that'll be a triumph for the Tories. But it might be a problem for Cameron later, because it puts Boris in a much stronger position to get back into the Commons at the next election and challenge Dave's chum, Georgie, for the Tory leadership. There's been a stubborn stain in the British justice system, which even Theresa May hasn't been able to scrub out. The Home Secretary gleefully announced this week that the extremist Muslim cleric Abu Qatada is finally going to be deported.
Officers from the UK Border Agency arrested and detained Abu Qatada. Yeah. And served notice that we are resuming his deportation. The assurances and information that the government has secured from Jordan mean that we can undertake deportation in full compliance with the law and with the ruling of the European Court of Human Rights.
Only to discover the next day that he's lodged an appeal. She says it won't stand, and it all turns on how many days have elapsed since the original judgment. Well, how hard can it be to count them? It's even a leap year. I know the Home Office is slightly shambolic, but yet of course civil servants can count to 29. Cameron's got to clean up his act, fast. It's bad enough if voters don't agree with what he's doing, but if they think he's weak and incompetent and willing to do a U-turn whenever he's criticised, well, that's a whole lot worse.